In the final years of the Han Dynasty, after suffering heavy losses in the Battle of Red Cliffs, warlord Cao Cao was forced to retreat. Your goal is to help Cao Cao navigate through the fortified lands, swipe away opposing forces, and reach the exit. The first level might be easy, but the difficulty ramps up quickly as you adventure further into the game. The game was created with a live audience. With suggestions from my viewers, together we built this project in just 12 live stream sessions. And the best part is, because Flutter is multi-platform, we can release it on Windows, macOS, Linux, Android, iOS, and the web, all from the same codebase. At a high level, the app can be divided into three parts: the background layer, the game board, and the puzzle pieces. Each puzzle piece also comes with a pair of interlocking attachments and a shadow for some added depth. They are then stacked as different layers, to make sure they always appear in the correct order. The color palette is configured as an inherited widget, so its values can be modified in one place and easily accessed elsewhere in the widget tree. The puzzle pieces are made from animated position. In Flutter, implicit animation widgets like these are super easy to use. Just give them a duration and an optional curve. They will automatically animate when their values are changed. For the duration, I first check if the window size is different from before, and if so, I pass in 0. This is to skip the unwanted animation when the app is being resized. And for the curve, I use Ease Out to simulate physical objects being slowed down by friction. To handle user input, I add a gesture detector. I use the onUpdate event instead of onEnd event here. This reduces input lag, allowing the game to react before the gesture ends. For the reset button, I also added a mouse region widget to make it glow when it's being hovered. The step counter is another example of utilizing implicit animation widgets in Flutter. It's also wrapped in a value listenable builder, so it can always keep up with the steps. I've published this widget as a package on Pub and made a video explaining how it was made. If you like this animation, you can import it to your own project. The game board is mostly a container. I used a backdrop filter to blur everything behind it, and a shader mask to create a beam effect. Since we want the beam to keep dancing around, it's easier to use explicit animations with a controller. Also, these exit arrows and those text highlights are all made with Flutter's explicit animations. Lastly, I used a custom paint for the background. A text painting version was first implemented but later scrapped because having to lay out texts every frame caused some performance issues on the web. The simplified version looks similar but performs much better, even on low-end devices. So as you can see, thanks to Flutter's modularized design where everything is a widget, we can easily divide a project into smaller parts. And with all these built-in widgets and easy-to-use animations, you too can quickly make apps in Flutter and target multiple platforms at once. If you're interested, I've also made a lot of video tutorials on many topics, such as animations, keys, layouts, slivers, and much more. I also post challenge questions for my viewers, and then do follow-up videos to discuss all the creative solutions I receive, so we can learn from each other. If you haven't yet tried Flutter, you should check it out at flutter.dev.